Доктор, пригласить Джуди доктора Курьянски, Джуди Курьянски, который является представителем представителем Международной ассоциации прикладной психологии Всемирного совета психиатрии ООН, то есть глобальная повестка дня Всемирного совета по психиатрии, Всемирного по психическому здоровью, положил финансовый финансовый международный значимый
всем. Спасибо. Очень важно оценивать то, что имеет фундаментальное значение для психического здоровья и благополучия. Я рад, что здесь есть и представители органов государственного управления, не только специалисты психиатрии, то есть все готовы взаимодействовать в решении наших задач. Большое спасибо Наталье, а также председателям Союза по психическому здоровью, а также большое спасибо Ольге Пызиной, которая заслуживает самой высокой оценки за деятельность волонтеров, а также всем моим коллегам, которые уже выступали, а также всем тем, которые сумели создать такую прекрасную выставку.
Great honor to be here. Two years ago, I talked about some of the issues at the United Nations and what has gone on with the advancement of mental health and well-being. And so I'll do an update about that and tell you what has been going on in the UN on the global and international level. I also have great appreciation for all the education that has gone on here.
Следует отдать должное тем образовательным инициативам, которые имеют место в России
и они участвуют с Лигой психотерапевтов
в Сибири. Я тоже очень рад отметить их участие. Также несколько слов о декларации по психическому здоровью и вопросам образования. Пожалуйста, внесите свой посильный вклад. Здесь тоже очень много говорится о том, как следует организовать это образование. То есть это все должно найти свое отражение в декларации. Я много потратил, тяжелых лет своей жизни, работая в качестве журналиста, работала и на Гаити, в Китае, в Японии, когда имели место всякие природные катастрофы, землетрясения, наводнения и так далее.
Также специальные презентации о музыке. Музыка, музыкальные композиции, это тоже из ООН. Мы тоже это тоже делали в 2002 году с Далай Ламой. Это музыкальные такие мероприятия. И матрешка – символ России. И на этой конференции это идея дружбы, а также каких-то удивительных вещей, а также фертильности и возможности для роста на национальном и международном уровне. Это такой ключевой момент в деятельности ООН. У нас много женщин, которые занимают лидирующие посты. И это приверженность генерального секретаря. Он говорит, что 50 на 50 должно быть его, так сказать, первый заместитель. Это женщина, представитель молодежи. Молодежи тоже женщина, раньше был мужчина, об этом тоже говорилось. Доктор Пазмияк, about universal health coverage. Next to her is Lady Gaga's mother. And Lady Gaga, do you all know who Lady Gaga is?
So there is a partnership that has been made by several of the leading governments at the United Nations who are leading the cause of mental health and well-being on the global agenda. And we have made a partnership with Lady Gaga's foundation as her mother presented, she has suffered, even though she's such a major music star, from tremendous anxiety all her life. So she is, in fact, a person with lived experience and creating this foundation.
туристами, в общем. And so this event, there you see Tedros, who is the director general of the World Health Organization, who has also included mental health in the World Health Organization's whole agenda. And of course, it always has been, but it is higher now and much more profile. And that's in fact me making a statement at that particular meeting about the history of what's gone on. Here, Vladimir showed this slide before about the fact that there was a meeting in London. You see the Secretary General here of the United Nations and the Director General of the World Health Organization. So you see there is high-level support for mental health, high-level support at the highest level of leadership in all of these international organizations that's so important. So now I'm going to play you a very, very short comment made by the Secretary General of the United Nations about the importance of mental health. This is astounding and major importance. Okay, so let's play this.
Дамы и господа, мы не должны никого оставить без внимания. Да, действительно, те, которые страдают от психических расстройств, они заслуживают лучшей участи и более широкой поддержки со стороны общества в целом. И в следующем месяце, я думаю, что мы начнем новую стратегию, инициируем новую стратегию по охране психического здоровья. То, что люди иногда оказываются в очень тяжелых обстоятельствах и ситуациях, и содействие укрепления психического здоровья везде, повсеместно. Действительно, очень удивительно, что Организация Наций ставит вопрос именно в таком ключе и заговорил об этом, скажем, в очень серьезном тоне. И теперь ведет на выступление is a major leader in the entire campaign about mental health and well-being at the United Nations at the level of the governments who are at the UN. So we'll hear from the Prime Minister of Canada supporting psychology and mental health at a recent meeting in Montreal of the International Association of Applied Psychology.
As psychologists, you're on the front lines of mental health for people around the globe, and you stay on the cutting edge of research to make sure your patients get the best care possible. Our government is working hard to support you. In budget 2018, we made record investments in science and research. In budget 2017, we included major support for mental health initiatives across Canada. It's the first time the federal government prioritized mental health in accordance with provinces and territories. We're committed to fighting stigma and helping people across the country get the mental health care they need.
Вот. И that's amazing. So we have the opportunity to work with Russia here now with regard to supporting mental health and well-being. And in the beginning of this campaign, I was very honored to be part of getting mental health and well-being, five words, promote mental health and well-being into the global agenda of the United Nations called the Sustainable Development Goals that you heard Dr. Pozniak mention. Before, and I'll show you the slide up as well. I did that in partnership with the ambassador of Palau, a small Pacific island state. So the Palau government was supporting mental health and well-being. It has been taken up, this campaign, by three governments at the UN. Think about what this triumvirate means. Canada, that you just heard the Prime Minister speak about, and Belgium, which is the queen of Belgium, is a psychologist and a major proponent of the Sustainable Development Goals and also of mental health and well-being and speaks around the world about it. And the third country is one from the Arab states. Can you guess which one it is? Which one?
It's Bahrain.
And
so Canada, Bahrain, and Belgium are leading this campaign about mental health and well-being. This is phenomenal. And they've created and continuing what I started started with the ambassador of Palau, the group of friends of mental health and well-being, promoting this throughout the government level so that the governments will support through policy mental health and well-being.
Now, you heard
Dr. Pozniak talk about from the WHO, the high-level meeting on NCDs. This is so important. A phrase that you will hear about this now is called 5x5. That means there are five conditions, not four. Diabetes, heart conditions, cancer, lung disorders, and mental health. And these are the five risk factors, so that's why it's being called 5x5. You may be hearing that phrase, so I wanted to bring it up to you. Another major advancement has been a General Assembly resolution about mental health and human rights. You heard human rights mentioned and how important that is in our consideration about mental health and well-being. Well, the General Assembly, the governments of the world, 193 of them represented at the United Nations, have agreed on a resolution about mental health and human rights and how those two are connected. This is a major step ahead for everything that we care about at this conference. The good news that you've been hearing about here, too, is that it makes good sense from an economic point of view, because the governments always say, well, what is the cost? You know, what is the benefit for us in terms of the bottom line? Even private enterprise will say that. And so you've heard, and it is important that the governments are recognizing it makes financial good sense for them to support mental health and well-being. So at the United Nations, we have what we call a psychology coalition, the World Council of Psychotherapy, one of the co-sponsors of this event, and Dr. Pritz is the president of, belong to a coalition. And we have a group of psychologists at the United Nations that I've been the president of, the coalition, who advocate about the importance of what we know in this room and convince governments about how important it is to put mental health in all policy considerations. These are the statements that we write, and we've handed out, some of you have gotten a piece of paper about it. This one was important. It was about the rights of persons with disabilities to decent work. This is a major issue, and an issue that many of you care about. And we wrote a very specific statement that was accepted into what's called the Economic and Social Council at the United Nations. This is major to have these kinds of international bodies recognize the issues that we're talking about here at this conference. Here you see the World Health Organization, WHO, last year had their annual World Health Day, which is coming up on the 10th, as we heard, on depression, let's talk, encouraging getting over the stigma and the silence and the shame, what I call the three S's about mental health issues. And the governments who supported that, France and Thailand and Japan, were at the leadership of this issue of universal health coverage. So you hear about all these governments. Think about it. You belong to some of them. I know some of you who come from these countries know that your country is making a difference in this issue. Here are the 17 sustainable development goals. Number four over there is quality education. Quality education, number four. Number three is good health and well-being for all. And so these two are the ones that we are concerned with now. And target 3.4, I was very honored to say that Ambassador Otto and I partnered in getting the countries to agree that this was important to put in the agenda. It was never there before. We would go to these meetings with different countries from all over the world and say, this must be in the agenda. Promote five words only to be in the agenda. And they would say, well, we care about poverty, we care about decent work, we care about peace in the world. Yes, of course, equality of women. But fundamental to all of that is, in fact, the idea that there must be mental health and well-being in order to eradicate poverty, in order to have empowerment of women, in order to have peace in this world. We need to have peace within, and that is mental health and well-being. That's the room where this negotiation took place, and here is what Ambassador Otto came up with. This mental health and well-being is at the heart
обозначил, это находится в центре внимания вот этой повестки дня, сердцевина, можно сказать, для того, чтобы добиться всех этих целей устойчивого развития, нам нужно тоже заниматься этой проблемой укрепления психического здоровья благополучия на период до 2030 года. И в условиях партнерства и сотрудничества многие люди об этом говорили, об этом работая совместно. Вот что важно. Это 17-я цель партнерства во имя достижения этих целей. И это посол Израиля ООН и правительство многих других стран мира, правительство Испании, Мексики, а также Российская Федерация был делегат, представитель, участвовал в этих переговорах.
And Canada and Belgium at the leadership, and you see myself over there as the advisor to this group since I was there from the very beginning, and Lady Gaga's mother, and many other countries from every place in the world, the European countries, Vietnam, Philippines, Benin, Liberia, Afghanistan, Israel, Ireland, Portugal, Brazil. It's astounding. The interest and the commitment is really exciting. Here's the Queen истинную заинтересованность. А это королева Бельгии, о которой я раньше говорил. Она сама психолог по образованию, является пропагандистом и защитником интересов психического здоровья. Психического здоровья. Нужно ликвидировать, искоренить стигму, а также в том числе искоренение Эболы, характер Эболы. Я также упомянул об этом и раньше. Китай и Куба тоже входят в эту группу, также Марокко,
and the ones that you would expect. It was supported by a country dear to my heart because I went to Sierra Leone during Ebola and after, and it was organized by the country of Sierra Leone. Think about all these countries being so committed to this issue. Technology, we've also heard, is so important, and so many of the events that we have at the UN focus on youth who are using, of course, because they know this better, the technological tools с которыми сталкиваются наши молодые, технологические инструментарии укрепления психического здоровья благополучия. Это же проблема, так сказать, с проявлением насилия в школах и так далее. Также ликвидация последствий ураганов и других разрушительных природных катастроф. Также инструмент, который мы используем в качестве инструмента